Hey, check out this cool backflip.
So now, I think you might know that now, I move pictures now.
Okay, do you know what this thing is? Huh? Have you? Have you ever seen this thing?
I'm assuming you haven't.
That's what we're gonna talk about today. So without further ado, let's, the history of the American.
There once was a man named George Washing Machine, and he really wanted to make an American Foxhound or something like that, I don't know. But you see, he never could because he had to deal with these Foxhound things. You see, these things were useless. Well, they were not
really
useless,
me?
But they were still pretty useless. You know, they were not too effective. So George Washington had an idea, and he wanted to make, you know, that dream happen. But unfortunately, George Washington couldn't fulfill his dream because the government was all like, "Hey, man, we kind of need you right now. We kind of just need to, like, you know, to invite you to some village. You know, I think they need help. So go do that." So George, with no choice, had to do that. He found it really difficult to do that. He found it difficult as he couldn't ride on his horse or his foxhounds. George Washington almost felt like giving up. But then all of a sudden, a girl named Elizabeth Willing Powell, or something like that, came to the rescue and saved George Washington. But how did she recognize him in the first place? Well, I will demonstrate. In song form! Hey there, Washington, I got really, really good news for you. I'm just here to say that your dog's very handsome and cute. I'm just saying that your dog's handsome. You better not sell it, or you'll be Samsung. Don't be a dumb butt and say that he's bad. Cause if you do so, I will be very mad. Come on, come on, hurry up, inviting you to dinner. After dinner, I'm bringing you to a club I think you'll really like. Don't be so absurd and consider that I'm kidnapping you. I'm obviously bringing you to people who like fox hunting too.
FBI, open up!
Put your hands up in the air! Put your hands up in the air! We finally got the criminal! We finally got a report! A report! We finally...
So after that weird, encounter, after dinner, George Washington finally got into that club as he was greeted with a bunch of epic gamers, such as himself, that also really liked fox hunting. I think they got along pretty well, you know,
gamers.
They chatted,
like,
you know,
Fortnite.
Like, hey man, do you like fox hunting like we do?
Yeah.
You guys do too?
Oh yeah, man, we love fox hunting.
Yeah,
you don't even know, man.
Yeah, fox hunting is like finger licking good, you know? George Washington, wasn't it? Oh, yeah, dude. At first, I didn't really like you because, you were, like, part of the government and stuff, you know, and us gamers like us, we don't really like, you know, to support the government, but every fox hunting lover is a friend of ours, and, you know, and we respect you, you know? So, yeah, I guess we can respect you, you know? I respect you, man. And then they all became friends, and, you know, and they shared their passions and everything about fox hunting, and it all went really well.
One revolutionary war later.
George Washing Machine, after the war, retired in Mount Vermont. And, you know, he was retired, you know, he was just relaxing on his relaxation chair, just chilling up in the mountain high. But George Washington didn't have time for that. George Washing Machine had bigger and better ideas. He wanted to fulfill his dream of making the ultimate foxhound. So George Washington yeeted his relaxation chair all the way to T-Series headquarters. And while we're at it, let's just rename T-Series to Trash Can Series, okay? So George Washington, after destroying his relaxation chair, decided to now fulfill his dream and work on his foxhound. But he wasn't gonna do this alone. He needed help, so he decided to call Handsome Squidward over here, known as Marquis de la Fay. And after lots of careful and creative maneuvers, they finally made the American Foxhound. Everything was going pretty swell for George Washington. You know, he just made a new dog breed and everything. And,
You know, he still keeps in touch with his friends, you know. Everything's been going swimmingly, you know. But then, the fateful day came. Something horrible happened. No, the Fire Nation did not attack. Probably something worse. Oh no, it's here. The government is here! Oh no! What do they have to do for me now?
George Washington, I am here to say that you have to go back to your political issue things. You have to join us back!
No, I promise, I never would have joined you! No, not a chance! Not ever! I made my own promise! I chose a path and I am willing to take it! You can't! I won't join back!
Oh... George Washington, you fool! You will join us, no matter if you like it or not.
Oh yeah? Then how are you gonna make me, huh? No one's gonna make... You're not gonna make me! You're not gonna make me join you!
I'll make you the first president of the United States.
Where do I sign up?
Will the American Foxhound be able to see the light of day again? Is George Washing Machine gonna be able to take off that dumb mask? Is Mr. Moser gonna take away the privilege of making a fun video on my dog project because this video is so weird? Find out next time on Dragon Ball Z! Previously on Dragon Ball Z!
So yeah, George Washington had to go back because of political issues or something. And he had to become president of the United States. But there was problems that he had to face. And he couldn't do them alone. Luckily, his epic gamer friends were able to help him fund for a college and earned enough V-Bucks to get him into the college so they can support him to become the President of the United States. So yeah, George Washington then became the first President of the United States, as we all know, and you know, the rest of his life was great and amazing and you know, all stuff for another day. But unfortunately, he lost the respect of his gamers and now he'll never be the same. I'm pretty sure PewDiePie met George Washington, but he's too sad to share it with anyone. I know, because I know PewDiePie. And yeah, that's basically the story of the American Foxhound. I have to admit, not everything in the video, I just think, was all true. Most of it was true, and basically the whole thing, the base of it is true. But, you know, PewDiePie didn't really, meet George Washington. And Elizabeth Willing Prowl or something like that did not get arrested for attempting to kidnap George Washington. All that didn't happen. I just put that in just to make it fun, you know. I didn't want to make some boring history lesson, you know. You know, cuz we already have that. I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding, Mr. Mother. You're a good teacher. Also, make sure to like and subscribe, and follow me on Twitter, follow me on Instagram, and especially TikTok. Please subscribe to TikTok. I have like 70 alternative accounts, and I make billions of money from TikTok and Musical.ly. Don't forget Musical.ly. TikTok and Musical.ly. That's my bank account is overloaded. I have money.
I'm just kidding. I don't have a YouTube channel. Or Twitter account, or Instagram. Anyway, this is starting to get a little too long. Sorry. There's so many jokes I wanted to cram in there. I'm sorry. Earthquake happening. My cat's on fire. Bye.